A key part of OSIsoft's AMI solution is the exposure of the meter structure to users so that they can browse and explore and look at meter data in an organized fashion. And a key part of that is PIAF. PIAF allows us to store all those meters as assets. So when we have a graph, we can actually look at a particular meter or switch between meters very easily. But one of the special parts about this is how do we take a meter and actually create that asset in PIAF? So to start with, we have the PIAF server, and it is responsible for organizing meters into assets, or organizing all that usage data so we can make sense of it. Because the PI server has thousands and thousands of points of data, but that's useless to us if we have no way of organizing it, of looking into it, or looking for a specific meter. So again, we have an archive. It has lots of data in it. And the AF server makes sense of that data and allows PyCoreSight or PyProcessBook or PyDataLink to display that data. You might think of PyAF as taking the meters and reorganizing them back into the original households they came from. Okay, so we have a data source and we have the Pi interface. And like most or all Pi systems, data will flow from the data source to the Pi servers. The data source is a head end. We call it the head end. Now, it's a piece of software that just works with all those meters. And then we have PISCC. PISCC is the intermediary. It's the connection block between all this stuff. The brains of PISCC is the master table. This keeps track of all the meters we have, all the AF assets that are linked to those meters, and all the Pi tags. So it's really important. It holds a lot of stuff. Upon installing PISCC, some configuration of the PIAF server needs to happen. So there's a couple template files. There's just a number of XML files that hold templates for meters. So for example, when we create a new meter in AF, we want it to automatically have a few attributes with it, such as the amount of power consumed or the status of this meter, and maybe the serial number of the meter, say. So upon installing, we'll take those XML files and we'll import them into the AF library, which is where we store all of the AF templates. So this is one time at installation. Now, this is all stored in the PIAF database. PIAF. Now, upon creating a new meter, we're going to look at the flow of information of that structure data. So first off, it goes to the head-end software, and then it'll be sent to PISCC and written to PISCC as an XML file. It's also possible that PISCC would go poll for this structure data, but for this example, we'll say it wrote an XML file on PISCC. That'll be inputted into the master table, and then it will be sent to a create queue. So this create queue is creating a new asset on AF. Because we might be creating thousands of meters at once, there's a queue for them so that we can get to them as they come. There's also a sync queue, and we'll talk about that function in just a moment. Okay, so step one, step two, step three, step four, step five, go create an asset in PIAF. Once it's created, PIAF will send a confirmation back to the PI interface. Yes, I created the asset. Then it's put into the sync queue, and the sync queue is asking PIAF, hey, what's the unique identifier of that asset you just created so that we can store it in the master table? PIAF responds with that GUID, and it's entered into the table. PISCC also coordinates PIAF and the Pi server so that the Pi assets, the assets in the AF tree, are linked up with the Pi server tags. So when, for instance, we view a tag in PyCoreSight, we can see the tag data through the AF asset. Okay, we'll talk a little bit about troubleshooting right now. So first off, you want to always view these files if you suspect there's problems. If we suspect there's problems in the queue file, we'll use queuesclient.exe. If we suspect there's a problem in the AF server, we can use Pi System Explorer. If we suspect there's a problem in the head-end software, we can use the headendtest.exe, and that'll be named according to the head-end software's name. And if we suspect there's a problem with the table, we can use tablesclient.exe. This allows us to peer into any of these files. Now, it's benign to look at these files, but you should never edit or delete these files directly without specific instruction from OSIsoft to do so. One final note. Whenever the PI-AF server is syncing with new meters, nothing else such as PI System Explorer, nothing else should be writing to that PI-AF database. Doing so could cause an inconsistency and we'd have to reinitialize the entire system. So, if you can, make that PI-AF database read-only to everything except for PI-SCC.